Hello viewer, welcome to Artistry. I am Lidya Kimue from SOS Technical Training Institute, and we are learning how to make a shot. Today, we shall learn how to make the fly front opening. Having cut our fly front, we have our three pieces. These are called fly pieces. So we have three pieces because we are making the zip fly opening. We shall pick two left hand pieces and stitch the outer edge, which is the curved end. Make your seam. Your seam can be as little as 1/4 inch, but the most it should be is 1/2 inch. When you get to the curve, curve slowly and reverse stitch. Cut off. My machine has unthreaded, so I will rethread it. Once you have made your seam, if it is more than 1/4 inch, trim the seam allowance to 1/4. At the rounded end, snip. And that is how it should look when you have snipped. Cut off any hanging threads. Yeah. Then turn your fly piece to the right side, and you should iron and knife edge this curved area or the seam that you have made. When we say knife edging, it means you let the seam allowance form your fold line right at the seam line. Let that seam line form your fold line. So you fold right at the seam line and iron. Once you have ironed with the curved area on the right hand, take your zip and place it on the edge that has not been stitched, or the raw edge, and stitch your zip down. Right at the edge of the zip. If you do not have a zipper foot, open up your zip tab to the end and stitch your zip down. Thank you. zip up your zip, and that is the way your piece should look after you have stitched the zip. Now pick your trouser or your short piece and stitch right at the seam allowance up to the mark for the zip opening. Your zip opening should be around 6 inches or 7 inches at the most. 6 is preferable. So you stitch and leave your zip opening of 6 inches plus your seam allowance on the top. Make a plain seam. Curve at the crotch line. And always remember to knife edge your seam. Always remember to reverse stitch at the beginning and at the end of the seam. Now we shall not neaten the seam allowance because we shall use this edge of our fly to neaten that end using the binding method. So once you have made your seam, we shall now apply our zip with the fly. Remember, this is a man's short. Therefore, the zip with the fly will go to the right hand side, and the other fly front piece will go to the left hand side. So let us apply the zip, the right hand side fly piece. As you apply this piece, remember we have a seam allowance of half an inch. Roll out a bit of that seam allowance to the right side. That means your seam allowance reduces, and we have some of your seam allowance showing on the right side. This will allow our zip to lie flat and be completely concealed inside the opening. You could finger press to hold that seam line down. And now place your zip at that point and stitch it down. As you stitch the zip, open up your zip tab and stitch close to the fold line. Remember to retain the rolled over seam allowance. This should be between like 1/4 inch or half to 0.6. millimeters. Ensure you stitch very close to the fold line. Keeping the rolled out seam allowance even. Your stitching line should go slightly beyond the zip opening. And by so doing, we have now applied the right hand side of the fly front. That is the way it should look. Notice that your stitching line is inside or beyond the seam line of the crutch. Now we shall go to the left hand side. Pick your fly piece with the extension, right sides together. Place it on the right side of the short. And this time you will stitch on the exact seam allowance or the seam line, or where your line should be, where the seam of your crutch should be. That is at half an inch. Attach the fly piece right to the end of the seam line. Cut off your thread. And understitch. When we understitch, we stitch the seam allowances to the facing. So how shall we do this one? These are the seam allowances. We shall stitch them to the zip, to the fly front piece, and we understitch from the right side. So turn it to the right side. I need to cut off that thread. Ensure your seam lies flat. Finger press to try and make sure it is open or it's well pressed right at the seam. And start stitching. Your understitching should be as close as possible to the seam line. And yes, always ensure that your seam lines or your stitching lines are straight. Crooked stitching lines don't look good in garment making. That is the way your fly front piece should look. I will press it flat, but first we now attach this piece . Snip at the bottom to turn the seam allowance to one side . Just snip the seam allowance alone. don't go beyond the stitching line and turn the seam allowance to one side like that. Then continue stitching your fly front extension or binding onto that seam allowance. Up to the end. Yeah. And then now, once that seam allowance has been stitched in the first row, lay your left hand piece over your right hand piece on the seam line. Remember, we rolled in the right hand piece inwards, and it should lie flat and conceal or hide the stitching line for the right hand side. Then lift your short, and you should be able to see your fly piece. Take your fly piece and your zip, just the two of them, the fly piece and the zip. Have the zip come to the right side. While holding your zip down, stitch the zip to the fly piece, and you're stitching the zip only right at the edge of the zip. Right at the edge of the zip. When you get to the zip tab, ensure you have your needle down and open up your zip. You could use your scissor to push it open and continue stitching your zip down. That is how your zip should look. Notice that there is equal distance all the way, and it is only stitched to the fly front alone, not to the short. After you have done that, then you can now stitch the fly front piece to the short. Before you do that, edge stitch this end of the fly front. You could also bind it or overlock. I will edge stitch, fold like a quarter, edge stitching this because we shall now stitch it down and will not be able to access it for knitting. Ensure that there are no threads all the time as you stitch. Fold the corner well. cut off your thread. Yeah, that is how the edge stitching should look like. Then now we shall hold that fly piece down. Have your zip tab on top. Have your fly extension or the fly piece on the right hand side, push it away from the opening so that now you can hold the fly front piece to the shot. And to do so, you will need, you can draw your fly front stitching line, which should be 1¼ inches or 1 inch, whatever you choose to use, ensure that it is even. So I shall stitch over that line with my other fly pieces away so that I do not stitch them together. Start at the base. Ensure that you have knife edged and stitch down the fly piece. Curve gradually, do not turn or pivot, but just curve gradually as you stitch. And we always make that seam or that stitching line from the right side of the garment. Cut off your hanging threads. Then now, hold your right hand fly pieces together with your left hand fly piece and hold them together, just a small section. You can do this by machine or by hand. I will do it by machine. A stitching line of about 1/2 inch to 3/4 and reinforce it. This is at the end or the lower end of the opening. You realize that the opening is at that point, and I have cut the pieces together at this point. The opening is at that point, and I've cut them at this point. Now, we still have our edge to knitten. We had knitted the bias or the binding strip. Now we place it on top and stitch it down. Let it conceal or hide the other stitching line that we had done before. Cut off any other extra piece. This ensures that our end is also knitted. I will cut off those hanging threads. And now go to the iron box to iron our piece. If you look at the fly front, you will see that our fly front has been done. And the zip is now attached. I'm just neatening my piece. And the zip is functional. You can open. You will always have that extension showing, and this other side, on the left-hand side, the extension is not there. And your zip, when closed, the only stitching line you should see is that on the left-hand side. There is no other stitching line that you should see. That is how we make the fly front zip opening. Let us iron and see how it lies flat. Iron your piece. And you can see our opening lying flat. I'll open the tab so that I'm able to iron the top. And I will also iron the crotch line. Remember, we said any ironing given to a garment as you work on it is called under pressing. And when you're stitching garments, that's the most important part, to always under press. That is the way the fly front opening should look like once it has been made. We have come to the end of the lesson, viewer. I have been your teacher, Lidya Kimue, from SOS Technical Training Institute in Buruburu, and you are watching me on Elimu TV. See you next time. We've come to the end of the lesson. Thank you.